Hi, tonight we're going to talk about science, spirituality, Christ, and physics. Science at this time is validating spirituality, and spiritual traditions are using associations with light and energy as attributes of God. Light draws attention to subtle energy and illumination, but also insight, understanding, and divinity. In the light, we see where we are going, so it's reasonable so we don't lose our balance or footing in darkness. In the spirit, we allow divine light to reveal itself in many ways and in many dimensions. But in the human mind, we only see 1% of the visible light spectrum, so miss the majority of reality. Everything is energy connecting everything to each other, and we are all suns shining and sharing light. But while we become aware of our light, enlightened, we have to see that light is present in everyone and everything. Like God, it is present in everyone, everywhere, and all-pervading, powerful, and knowing. Because light is the light of consciousness, which is in everything. The universe is trying to communicate with us through scientists, nature, and everything around us because we are a spark in it. We just need to have an open mind to receive the info and blessings by turning down the noise that is misleading and misusing the truth. Plato said, "We can easily forgive a child who is afraid of the dark. The real tragedy of life is when men are afraid of the light." The Bible says, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." John 1:5. Jesus said, "You don't understand now what I am doing, but someday you will." John 13:7. Faith in God is compatible with science because God created the world and nature, while science studies the world and nature, so it can bring us closer to God. Therefore, scientific findings become religious discoveries that lead to revelations and insight. But religion has become a business of building temples and churches to house people where they tell us to be quiet and listen to their stories. God is with us in science, but religion, people don't like it because they are competing with it, when they should be using science and silence for self-realization to find God. Religious people are afraid of discoveries, thinking they reject religion, but they are only giving us direction. Stephen Hawking said, "God may exist, but science can explain the universe without the need for a creator." Albert Einstein said, "The most beautiful thing we can experience is the mysterious. It is the source of all true art and science." Einstein also said, "The more I study science, the more I believe in God." Jesus was crucified because he said, "I am one with God the Father." He had a mystical experience with the divine consciousness of the Father, which science labels energy that is in everything and connects everything. The infinite consciousness is energy that carries information where the past, present, and future exist simultaneously, because nothing is outside the infinite. This experience of the mysterious transformed Christ and will turn anyone into a divine channel of spiritual energy. Jesus was centered in this divine light, so knew that this energy was within everyone and everywhere around us. This divine consciousness that Jesus called Father was not a separate superior being above us, but the core essence of who we are, which is energy. This consciousness is always present in those who realize that it is in everything. They see this subtle energy that creates, that carries information in every manifestation, and they know it is never separate from us. They see God everywhere, so do not harm others or themselves, even if they realize they are not the body and do not die. The Upanishads say, you are it. The divinity you seek outside and recognize outside is actually your innermost being. Carl Sagan said, how is it that hardly any major religion has looked at science and concluded, this is better than we thought. The universe is much bigger than our prophet said. Grander, more subtle, more elegant. Instead, they say, no, 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 my God is a little God, and I want him to stay that way. The discovery of quantum physics is saying the same thing that the sages of old said, which is that energy is the base of all life. We learn that the atom is 94% empty space. Therefore, our senses only experience about 6% of reality. And that means our physical body is only 6% of who we are. According to the quantum field theory, the particles in our body are manifestations of an excited field. Every part of this field is one with the universe. Therefore, all electrons, energy, is in the same field. So Jesus was right. We are one with the Father. Everything in our physical world is made of energy, which is a field of giving and receiving energy, and this energy carries information in the form of consciousness. That is why the answers are inside us. And the deeper we go in the inner journey, the more energy and consciousness is channeled from our spirit. This consciousness is released, that is released is the voice of God in our soul, a gift called grace. Amit Ray says, God is dancing in our breath, singing in our thoughts, and celebrating in our DNA. When you understand that God, fears evaporate, eternity arises. Yogananda said, if religion means primarily God consciousness or the realization of God both within and without, and secondarily a body of beliefs, tenets, and dogmas, then strictly speaking, there is but one religion in the world, for there is but one God. Wayne Dyer said, there is a universal intelligence that we call God or soul or spirit or consciousness, and it is everywhere and in all things. Quantum physics shows us that we are one with everything, like Jesus is being one with the Father, beyond what our senses are aware of. In the unified quantum field, everything, time, everybody, and our consciousness are united in a field of potentials. It already exists, so we are either aware of it or not aware of it. Factors associated with consciousness, such as intention, emotions, feelings, and our thoughts, sense a potential in the quantum field, and that it is becoming the energy of our future. Then, becoming aware of that potential, the observation causes fields of energy to collapse, forming particles called quantum events. This causes particles to manifest to give us an experience in the physical world. This is mind over matter, which is consciousness influencing matter. Albert Einstein said, concerning matter, we have been all wrong. What we have called matter is energy, whose vibration has been so lowered as to be perceptible to the senses. There is no matter. Max Planck, who originated quantum physics, said, I regard consciousness as fundamental. I regard matter as derivative from consciousness. We cannot get behind consciousness. Everything that we talk about, everything that we regard as existing, postulates consciousness. Amit Goswami said, consciousness is not mind. It is the ground of all beings, the ground of both matter and mind. Matter and mind are both possibilities of consciousness. Thank you.